Everyone knows that 0 times anything equals 0. But why? Your intuition is probably telling you that multiplication is repeated addition, and if I add 0 copies of something, then of course I have 0 things. If you have a bit of math knowledge, you might go beyond intuition and say that's just how multiplication is defined. 0 is the base case, 0 times anything equals 0, and multiplication of larger numbers is defined by saying y plus 1 times x equals y times x plus x. But we use the symbol 0 for a lot more than just the natural numbers. 0 the natural number times anything equals 0. 0 the real number times anything equals 0. 0 in modular arithmetic times anything equals 0. The 0 matrix times anything equals 0. The constant 0 function times anything equals 0. And even the 0 function convolution anything equals 0. These are all different types of zeros and different types of multiplication. They're definitely not simple repeated addition. And yet, we still end up with 0 times anything equals 0. Why? Let's prove it and see what about 0 actually makes this happen. Start with the expression 0 times x. For now, you can assume these are real numbers, but we'll see shortly that's not necessary. 0 is 0 plus 0 because 0 plus anything is that thing. Then because addition distributes, this is 0 times x plus 0 times x. At this point in the proof, we don't know that 0 times x equals 0, but we know that it's some number, and we know that number has a negative. So let's add that negative to both sides of the equation. Then group with parens, and since the number plus its negative is 0, we get 0 equals 0 plus 0 times x. And since, again, 0 plus anything is that thing, we finally arrive at 0 times x equals 0. In this proof, the only facts we really used are that 0 plus anything equals that thing, that addition distributes over multiplication, that every number has a negative that cancels it to give 0, and if you want to be real technical, we did also use associativity to group parens. We don't even need commutativity of addition or multiplication, which is good because matrix multiplication is not commutative. If you're applying for grad school, you might describe this as the identity for an associative invertible operation is absorbing for any other operation that distributes over the first. That's why it works for matrices, functions, convolutions, and many more. Because all these types of objects satisfy common axioms, which in particular include the properties we need. And no, this does not prove that 0 times infinity equals 0. The proof only works if 0 times infinity is defined so that we can do algebra on it, but 0 times infinity isn't defined, so no proof. Although, if you're a teacher, it's a fun exercise to ask your students to explain why the proof breaks down for infinity. Anyway, you're probably wondering, well, what about those assumptions? Is there a similar trick to show that 0 plus anything equals that thing? It feels like a very similar kind of problem. Usually, this is just shown manually because the behavior of 0 under addition is closely aligned to the definition of addition itself. A lot of the time, you give the label 0 to an element of your number system precisely because it has the property that it does nothing under your addition. So maybe the real question is, how do we normally define addition at all? Great question, maybe a topic for another video. Thanks for watching. As always, thank you to my viewers who support the channel through Patreon and other forms of donation. Slap that like button an odd number of times, and I'll see you in the next one.